I wanted to introduce myself real quick. My name is Dian Taylor. I work for RSM as a pre-sales director in business applications. I've also have several LinkedIn Learning courses on LinkedIn Learning as well. I'm a Microsoft MVP. And then you also see some links below as well to my website, to my YouTube channel. Feel free to connect with me on LinkedIn as well. I'm an open networker, so I'm going to accept all of those invitations. So let's just go ahead and dive right in. I wanted to kind of use a couple of slides first to kind of explain what this session is going to be about. So I'm going to show you how we can allow your Copilot agent to search knowledge articles from Dynamics 365 customer service or contact center. So the scenario normally goes like, right, your customer or your prospect goes to your website, they click on that little chat icon, and then they initiate a chat that way. Then an agent is assigned to that chat, and then the agent is going to try to help your prospect or your customer fix whatever reason, right, that they reached out. So it's going to say, hey, did you try this? How about this? You need to do this. And sometimes, obviously, there's not going to be a resolution that's found by the AI agents. So what we then see happening is escalation, right? And this is really now where a human is going to get involved. So now that conversation is being escalated, a customer service rep, a human is being assigned. The human can then try to resolve the issue by looking through knowledge articles, right, that are in that Dynamics 365 customer service or contact center instance, right? And then lastly, hopefully then we can go ahead and resolve the issue. Now, what we're trying to accomplish here with the solution that I'm going to show you today is kind of take out that human interaction, right? What if the Copilot agent would have access to the knowledge search, right? And that's kind of what I'm going to show you here today. So instead of now escalating to a human, we can actually have the agent search through the knowledge, resolve the issue, and still, if needed, obviously, there's still going to be that escalation path that is available as well. So let me go ahead and show you what exactly that looks like. So here you can see I'm in Dynamics 365 customer service, and I kind of wanted to show you first the knowledge articles, right, that is going to pull through here that my agent is going to have access to. It's going to search through. So I'm just going to go ahead and hopefully, yeah, I was going to say, this is not supposed to take this long. So here you can see a list of the published articles that I have in this environment. And I also, because we actually have the ability to set these articles to for only internal use, right? And this could be articles related to maybe how do I log an expense report, but we don't want Copilot to look at those types of articles, right? And give those to our prospects, our customers, et cetera. So that's kind of why I wanted to show you this as well. So you can see here, I have here an article about how to resolve a blue screen error, a Windows 11, and I also have a laptop charging issue. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go to Copilot Studio, right? We're now in Copilot Studio, and I'm going to open this CS Customer Service Agent. All right, so let's just make sure that we're actually going to the correct environment. There we go. Not sure what happened there, but I'm just going to go ahead and pull up Copilot Studio again so I can show you the agents. So again, let's go and take a look at my customer service agent here, and I'm going to first demo the functionality. Now, you saw earlier that we had that blue screen knowledge article inside of the customer service workspace. So that's the first thing I'm going to ask for. I'm going to say, okay, how can I fix a blue screen issue with my laptop? It's now going to search through those knowledge articles. There you go, right? And it's going to give me the details of that knowledge article. So this is pretty cool, right? So let's go ahead and do it again so you know that this is actually not a fluke. Let's try another one here. I'm going to say, hey, my laptop is not charging. Again, it's going to look through to see if it has any knowledge about that, any topics about that. And when it doesn't, it's going to look through that knowledge article. Now, lastly, let me actually show you here that it really was looking for just those articles. So I'm going to ask, what is the meaning of life? And again, right now in this particular case, it's going to say, I'm sorry, I'm not sure how to help you with that. Okay, so how did I do this? Well, first of all, if you have Dynamics 365 customer service, and I believe this is also included with Contact Center, there is a Power Automate flow that is actually part of the application. So currently I am in the default, as you can see over here, in the default solution in Cloud Flows. And the flow that you're looking for is the Search Dynamics 365 Knowledge Article Flow. So again, that's, you don't have to do anything. Again, if you have Dynamics 365 Customer Service or Contact Center, this flow is already in your environment. The only thing that you have to do, let me just go ahead and open this flow here. The only thing you have to do is you have to make sure that the connection references are connected the correct way. If you want to know how to do all of this, I created an article on this in detail and a video that you can find so that you can go through the exact steps on how to do that. Now, when we actually look inside of this particular Power Automate flow, you're going to see that this flow is not editable. So the other thing that you could do if you wanted to make some changes to this flow is just save your own copy of it, and then, right, you can make your changes. Now, I did want to show you this real quick, right? In the first two steps here, or the first you see inputs here, it's looking for the search text. This is what it's going to use to query for those knowledge articles, but it also has a filter here, right? So I'm going to have to use these inputs and set these inputs inside of Copilot Studio. So now that you've seen this, let's go back into Copilot Studio. So the only thing I've done here is I created a new topic that's called knowledge-based topic, because as you can see, there are no other custom topics in here, right? So this is a very simple setup. So I'm creating my new knowledge-based topic. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to redirect from another topic to this topic. And I'm going to explain that in a second. So you can see here, I have no phrases here from this particular trigger, because again, I'm going to point to this from another topic. I actually set a new variable, and this is because of that trigger that you saw in my Power Automate flow, right? We want to set this particular trigger. We want to feed that to that Power Automate inputs. If we don't do that, then the agent is going to ask, what do you want to use as a filter? And we don't want that, right? So then we're going to set the activity.text. That's really what your customer is entering in the chat. We're going to use that as the search, right? To search for those knowledge articles. And then we're going to get back JSON results, text results, and an article count. I really only care about text results, but since I'm going to call this particular topic from another topic, you need to make sure that you are going to allow this topic to return the values in this text result to the topic that's calling this one. Okay? All right. Now that we've set that up, we can go back to topics, and then we're going to go to system topics. Now, as you might know, we have something that is called a fallback topic. So if your agent doesn't understand the intent, right, of that particular message, right? I said, what's the meaning of life? And goes like, I have no idea what that means. So it's going to say, I'm sorry, I'm not sure how to help with that. Can you try again? That's kind of what you're seeing here. And this is an out of the box topic. So the only thing that I've done here is I added this redirect node. So I went over here, I said, topic management, go to another topic, go to my knowledge base topic. And because I just set that text result, as you saw earlier, right, to actually be able to get those results in the topic that called this knowledge base topic, that's why I'm seeing that over here. Then I added a condition to say, hey, if it if the text result is not blank, in other words, if it actually found an article, then I want to go ahead and say, here's the knowledge article that I found, and I want to paste the knowledge article in there. So that's what it did. If it doesn't find a knowledge article, it's going to say, I'm sorry, right? I'm not sure how to help with that. So in a nutshell, that's how all of that stuff was set up. Now, one more time, I just want to show you this real quick as we're tracking between topics, now that you understand the way that this was set up. Let's run this one more time. I'm going to go ahead and say, how can I fix a blue screen issue? You can see here, conversational boosting, not finding anything. It's sending it. It was really quickly, right, guys? But it did get me to this knowledge article and giving me this article directly here. You can kind of see here, right, the path that it followed as I was asking that question. And now it's going to redirect, did I answer your question correctly? And that's all I had for you guys today.